Okay, this is 2011 module 2. So you want a question 4. List 3 major components of an information technology system. 3 components will be hardware, software, and users, networking. Any one of those 4 would work. Using an automated ATM system, describe how input and output storage devices can be used. So you could go with input would be the keypad to put in the pin number. They could also have touch screens to choose options on the screen. Some ATMs have touch screens. Most ATMs will have touch screens. Output will be the screen to show the balance. And there would be also a printer that would be there to give you a transaction receipt. Then for storage, you would have, basically you'd have a hard drive inside the ATM machine that would store the values or update the data or something like that. So the values put in by the user would be stored on a hard drive, or the balance left, or something along those lines. You should be okay there. Using a suitable example, explain each of the following types of information of application software. First one is management information system, as a MIS. That's software systems that gather information to process it in order to find valuable trends or knowledge that could be applied to a business scenario. So you're really trying to apply it to a business. That's what you're looking for there. To help them move forward or something like that, because if they can't use the information to move forward, then you really have no hope. Example, human resource system, sales and marketing. Because it's an explain question or using a suitable, it says using a suitable example, you have to give an example. Next one is expert systems, which would be a software system that could take human knowledge and aggregate the information into a system with a user interface that allows people to ask questions of it as if they were talking to a real person or a real expert. Example, like webmd.com, where you put in your symptoms and you get what most likely is your diagnosis. Yeah. System development lifecycle is an important aspect of the development of information systems. Draw a label diagram to illustrate the SDLC. That acronym is PADIR. I usually kind of think of it as a name of a person named PADIR. Planning, analysis, design, implementation, and review. Implement and review. This is the answer that they normally have in the specimen paper or in like answer sheets. This is there are many different variations of the SDLC that I've seen, but this is the one that they usually quote when they are marking when they have a paper or when you're marking a paper. So just make sure that you line them up in a sort of waterfall model to show that they all go down into each other and that it could loop back to the top. And well, yeah, you could put them in boxes too. That would help if you feel like it. Various tools are used at each stage of the SDLC. For each of the tools specified below, state at which stage it will be most appropriately used, clearly explaining its function at that stage. So you want to do a Gantt chart. A Gantt chart is used at the, it could be at the planning stage, because it will kind of lay out, or it will lay out the steps or map the steps or stages that need to be followed for the whole project. A ERD or entity relationship diagram will most likely be in your design phase, the design stage, because it shows how the elements of the system would relate to each other. That'll give you the ability to build it better. Interview definitely be the analysis stage, because it would give you or it would gather information about the problem that will help you to solve it here. So 2 marks for each of those, you should be okay there. Explain why training is an important part of the system development process. Training would be important because you have to think along the lines of, okay, why would you need to train a user? Why would a user need to know how to use a system? Because more than likely, the users will break it. So it's important because users need to know how to use it properly, or else they will cause errors to occur in the system. Yeah. Alright, number 6 now. A network is a collection of computers interconnected by various transmission media. Transmission media may be wired or wireless. Explain 2 differences between a local area connection and a wide area network. So a LAN is a small in a small geographical location. It's usually there, and a WAN is usually in a large geographical location or a large geographical area. A LAN uses twisted pair cables, whereas a WAN may use fiber optic due to the distance because of the long distances. Yeah. State 2 examples of each of the following wired transmission media. Alright, wired, you have 3 choices. You have twisted pair, you have coaxial, and you have fiber optic. However you spell fiber, that's up to you. Wireless transmission media, you have radio waves, microwaves, you could even get infrared, you might also get Bluetooth, and you could get satellite also, if you want. For one of the wired and one of the wireless transmission media named in B above, discuss an application of its use. Alright, so twisted pair could be used in, it's set in a school environment, right? So twisted pair could be used to connect the computers in a lab, because it's a school, basically. But it's two marks, so you want to give a little more, so the computers could communicate with each other over the network. Something like that to warrant your 2 marks. And for the wireless, you could use microwaves. Microwaves could be used to create a Wi-Fi network. Microwaves could be used to create a Wi-Fi network so that students would be able to connect with their laptops to do schoolwork. Yeah. Distinguish between the 2 pairs of networking concepts, intranet. An intranet is an internal network used by employees of a company to share files and resources. Yeah, extranet now would be an intranet with access, or that gives access to external connections on a limited basis. Yeah, so like people who would connect to a network for a special purpose, like suppliers or whatnot. A MAN and a VPN. A MAN is a metropolitan area network. Metropolitan area networks are usually within cities or towns, so you would connect within a city, like a state, whereas a VPN is a virtual private network, which is a secure connection to a to a network via the internet. Yeah, it connects to an internal company network via a secure internet connection. And that's it for this module.